Item number, SCP-275. Object class, safe. Special containment procedures. Subject is to be contained within two 6-meter by 6-meter, 20-foot by 20-foot subterranean cells. That is only accessible by a freestanding overhead elevator, although she is allowed short-term access to the communal facilities contingent on good behavior, and is accompanied by no fewer than two operatives, all armed with gas grenades, filled with an incapacitating agent. Personnel are not to assist SCP-275's self-destructive behavior, unless authorized by Level 4 personnel. Such behaviors are either potentially harmful to bystanders, or pointless. Subject has requested 1 prayer rug, approved. 1 Quran, approved. Halal food, approved. To be allowed to perform a pilgrimage to Mecca, denied. Daily portions of chili pepper of a minimum Scoville scale rating of 1 million, approved. Contingent on good behavior. Regular haircuts, approved. Hot coals, denied. To be flogged, denied. To be stabbed, denied. To be beaten, denied. To be shot, denied. To be electrocuted, denied. To be set on fire, denied. Description: SCP-275 is a woman who cannot be physically damaged by any means available to the Foundation. Subject is of apparently Middle Eastern origin, and claims to have grown up somewhere in the Ottoman Empire, but to have been a homeless orphan with no memories before the age of approximately 10. Subject claims to be 168 years of age, despite appearing to be in her mid-30s. Subject is 1.63 meters, or 5 foot 4 inches tall, and weighs 190 kilograms, or 419 pounds. Again, despite having an appropriate and healthy sized figure. Hair and eyes are brown. She speaks most languages of the Middle East fluently, and speaks English with a mild accent. SCP-275 is perfectly normal in the fact that she needs to breathe, eat, and sleep. However, Subject is almost completely resistant to physical trauma, various forms of radiation, and extreme temperatures. By SCP-275's own recollection, her flesh has never experienced any damage, and her skin has never been pierced or scratched. Testing indicates that the majority of SCP-275's mass is composed of the elements common to all organic life. However, it is currently believed that many of the structural compounds have been replaced with significantly more durable substitutes, and the subject's tissues also appear to contain significantly elevated amounts of various heavy metals. Foundation researchers have thus far been unable to collect tissue samples. Attempts have been made to X-ray the subject, but results were inconclusive. Subject's skin contains significant quantities of radio-opaque elements, repelling most attempts to penetrate it with radiological or electromagnetic means. Diffractometry tests upon cell samples extracted from urine, feces, and menses indicate the presence of several novel polymers. However, the degree to which these polymers are represented in other tissues is speculative at best. This impenetrability of the subject extends through the entirety of the subject, including her hair and nails. Subject has claimed that her hair and nails have not been properly cut since she was 14, just before her condition manifested itself. In Foundation custody, her hair is to be cut by weekly exposure to a watt laser, and her fingernails and toenails are to be abraded with an angle grinder on a bi-weekly basis. In addition to this, due to her physical makeup and density, her biology has been slowed as well. Subject ages at least a fourth of the normal rate of aging. Also, her menstrual cycle is approximately 6 months long, with menses itself generally lasting for 3 to 4 weeks. SCP-275's mental state has been described by Dr. Glass as worrying, because her anomalous condition prevents her from experiencing most forms of sensation. She indulges in self-destructive behavior in an effort to perceive tactile stimuli. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-274, Graffito, right now. or for the complete course, watch this playlist.